Welcome back to World of Tanks with the Captain. Today I'm going to be taking a look at the WZ-132 Chinese Tier 8 light tank. So if you've played the 131, this tank will look immediately familiar to you because it looks almost identical. There's not much difference in its shape or the turret or anything. It's just basically the gun barrels are a little bit different. And that's about it visually. One thing you will notice is that it does have more hit points because it's tier up. So you get 1,050, which in my opinion is a bit low. I think it should have more like 1,100 or something, because the AMX 1390 that can do like well over 1,000 damage in like its burst clip, they can kill you in like 4 hits if they roll pretty well. So it's a bit annoying to have to go up against other tier 8 scout tanks when they can do that much damage in that short a period of time. So that part's a little bit annoying. I think this thing should get a hit point buff, or the 1390 should get smacked with the nasty stick, lose some hit points. Weight wise, it weighs about 24 tons, which equals about 2166 horsepower per ton. And that might at first not sound that great, but it does accelerate pretty well. It has a 520 horsepower engine, and it will get up to 65 kilometers per hour, which is 5 faster than the 131. Traverse is really fast at 56. This is one area where it beats the 1390 hands down, because the 1390 is only around like 40-ish. So we can look at armor, but basically, you won't be bouncing hardly any shots unless they hit this here. This is the only part on the tank that has virtually any armor. The only other shots you'll bounce are things that hit the tracks and get eaten by tracks. So, all in all, don't even consider this thing to have any armor ever, and you won't regret it. If you do try and bounce shots, like, it'll only be if you've angled a tank like this and someone's dumb enough to shoot right here, then you'll get a ricochet or something off the front. But otherwise, you don't really bounce anything because you don't fight tanks that only have 50 pen, and you had 50 pen down at tier 3. So, all in all, armor sucks. As far as module damage and stuff, if you get hit, you can almost count on someone dying or a module being broken. This thing is very fragile. Your guys die a lot. So honestly, it almost might be worth running this thing around with a spalliner. I would almost never recommend that, but it gets hit and you get mangled so bad when you get hit that it kind of hurts the tank a little bit sometimes. And that's mostly from in-team battles when you kind of have to, if you're the 132 and the other team has a 1390 and you got to 1v1 them. It's a little bit difficult sometimes. So we'll take a look at some other stuff down here. You got a turret traverse speed of 48. So the turret turns really fast, really great. And you've got a pathetic view range of only 400. Again, I've been complaining about light tanks and not having decent view range for a long time. I had a match in Lakeville where it was a tier 10 game, and there was a Leopard 1 that was probably about 400 meters away, and he spotted me when I wasn't moving, because I think I had part of my turret sticking out from behind a bush. And so tanks that have 400 view range and they're running coated optics can spot this thing no problem. Even if you're sitting open, you do not even pretend that you're a Hellcat or a T49 with this thing. The camo values I haven't found have saved this tank at all, even though I'm running with like on almost 100% camo on 3 of my guys and 35 on another guy. If you want to be invisible, you have to be probably about 400 or 500 meters away, or with a camo net on to be invisible if you want to sit out in the open. So, and that's mostly from tier 10 games. If you're running in a tier 8 game, you're a little bit better off. It's not as bad, but you're still. I've been fairly disappointed with the camo values of this tank on just how easy it is to get spotted. Considering that I've had Hellcats and T49s appear right in front of me, I thought this tank would be more on par with that, but it's not. So, just a little bit disappointed there. And I think the view range should be more like 450 to 440. It needs to be better than the tanks it has to spot. And unfortunately, Wargaming doesn't seem to understand how to balance the view ranges on the tanks properly. So we've got 750 signal range. That's great. Another thing that is quite good on this tank, you've got 520 horsepower engine, so you get going fast. You've got your two turrets. There's basically zero difference between them, except for one gets you 10 better view range, and it looks slightly different. You've got a huge assortment of guns. And we'll look at the guns in the research tree because it's kind of important with what happens here. So, on the 132, if you don't unlock this gun here, it kind of screws you when you get to this tank because to get to the turret and then the tier 9 gun, you have to unlock this gun. So, basically, you'll start off with both of these unlocked if you unlock them both on the 131. And this will help you as you go along down the line. So, what I ended up doing is I had this gun, and then I got the turret. And then I unlocked the 100 millimeter gun. And then I kind of had a thing where I was like, I am gonna just spend the last amount of EXP I have and get this other 85. So when you start off with this gun, it isn't actually a bad gun. You can use it with pretty good effectiveness against most of the stuff that you'll be outclassed fighting against. And then you have this gun here, which is like basically an upgraded version of the gun on the 131, and it doesn't have the hammerhead barrel like the other one does. So the main differences are basically you get about 13 more penetration, stock penetration from just shooting AP rounds, and same damage, except your accuracy improves by 0.2 to 0.34 from 0.36, and that's about it. You gain about 50 kilograms from buying the other gun. And I wouldn't even consider using this gun, so I'm not going to go over it. The main two gun. All right, had a technical malfunction there. My my video recorder to stop decided to stop recording. Thanks, Bandicam. So, back to the guns here. Taking a quick look at the guns. Again, the difference between the 85 and the 100 meter basically comes down to DPM. And you look at 7 here compared to basically 11. This one shoots every 5 seconds. This one is more like a medium tank gun that at tier 8 that shoots every 8 seconds. Except it's kind of the tier 9 gun that I would love to have on the Pershing. I would love to have this gun on the T-44 because it has pretty decent pen and the AP rounds are like the normal AP rounds penetrate a lot better. I mean, the Pershing has higher APCR, but it shouldn't have 270 or what it has anyway. So, it I really like this gun, but I would rather have this gun on a medium tank than a light tank. Its accuracy is okay at 0.36, and its aiming time is 2.3. My gun of choice is actually the upgraded 85mm 6485 TG gun. It is an 85mm gun, obviously, with 11 rounds per minute and 172 pen, which is obviously upgrade from the old one from 161-ish. And you'll see that it's more accurate than the 100 millimeter. It weighs about a ton less. It does 50 less damage, but sometimes you can get 400 damage out of this gun instead of just 250 because if you can get two shots in for every shot that everyone else gets to take, which is kind of the case sometimes, then it really does make a difference. It's kind of like having a heavy tank gun because it shoots twice as fast. You just have to penetrate, which is where this gun falls down sometimes with it's only got 230 on its heat rounds. And that's another main difference between this gun and this gun is the 85 uses heat. This one uses APCR. I wish this was APCR. I don't really like heat rounds the way they function in this game as much. But at long ranges, heat would probably be better anyway. But who knows? So my recommendation is to use the 85 or the 100. My preference is the 85, though. All right, back to the garage here. And I'll take a quick look at my modules. I'm gonna have maybe alter my setup. Currently, what I'm doing is I'm running it with a vertical stabilizer Mark 1 and coated optics to try and get my view range out of the toilet. and improved ventilation class 1. One of these might end up leaving at some point, and I might actually take that spall liner because I'm just sick of getting hit and having so much go wrong with this tank. And anyone who drives a 1390 or any of the other tanks will hopefully understand what I'm talking about. It takes so much personal health and module damage that I'm kind of getting to the point where I might try that for a little bit just to see if it actually works. So, my dudes here, obviously, Commander, you want Sixth Sense more than anything else. And everything else, I took camouflage. But honestly, at the end of the day, it's not really working against tier 10s. So I really don't know how useful this is in the end game. Against tier 8s, it's not bad. But if you're using this tank for team battles, this might matter a bit more. But against tier 10s with 420 view range and they're running binos and hiding at the back of the map, they're going to see you before you spot them. So I just kind of roll my eyes at it at this point. Until the scouts get fixed and they fix the TD view range or they fix their game. I'm not really, I don't know. I've got camouflage on this. I might as well pop all this shit off and put on something else because honestly, I don't really find that it works very well. Or maybe I'm just disillusioned with the horrible camo system in this game. So honestly, this is almost at 100%. I would probably take off-road driving on my driver. There isn't too much here that's that fantastic about the rest of this. Maybe snapshot to get those snapshot quick shots off and then run away kind of thing. Other than that, maybe repairs to get your tracks up because this thing gets tracked really easily. With your driver, there's a whole bunch of these I'd like to take. I wish these were spread out across some of the other things since a lot of the other classes really have useless skills that I don't really like. I would like off-road driving, I would like smooth ride, and I would like preventive maintenance, and I would like clutch braking, even though this thing already turns really fast anyway. So, the driver seems to have all the good skills other than the commander. On the final guy, which is the radio operator and the loader, I would probably end up taking safe stowage, because camouflage doesn't really work, and this thing gets ammo racked fairly easily. All this other stuff, I'd maybe take situation awareness, see a little bit further. Maybe signal boosting or relaying or something. But that's if I had like 3 or 4 or 5 crew skills. And I'm not sure if this... seeing as how the scouts kind of get kicked in the balls when it comes to how much experience you get and then credits you earn sometimes. I don't know. It might take a million years to get there. Who knows? So, ammo loadout. I usually take about 27 AP rounds, 12 heat rounds, and HE rounds. These I sometimes use to just shoot at higher tier tanks that I have absolutely zero hope in penetrating just to try and break stuff. And then I've got regular stuff for this. Nothing too crazy. And if you look at the tank tree for these guys, you can see that to get to this thing, you obviously go scout tank, scout tank, scout tank. And then scout tanks die off, and you have to go to the WZ-120, which is basically a Type 59 with a big derpy gun. And then you move on to another medium tank, the 121. You can also get to this tank from taking the medium line, but I haven't done that. I'll probably use it at some point. I actually like the Chinese tanks quite a bit. They're pretty interesting to drive sometimes. And yes. So, I'm not really caring about these two tanks quite as much. I wanted to get these light tanks, and out of all these light tanks, I like the 132 the most, because it's basically like an improved version of the 131. And it's just unfortunate that, I don't know, it's unfortunate that tier 9 and 10 even exist in this game at this point to me, because although I don't have any tier 9s, and that's kind of been my own fault, because I hate those two tiers. I hate playing against them, and I find the tanks are just crappy and unbalanced anyway, but that's just my opinion. I know a lot of people love tier 10 and that's all they play all day and how they rack up their damage and Fosh T57 kill people all day, but I just find that tier 8, I don't know, I think between tiers 4 and tier 8 are the best balanced tiers, but that's a different conversation for a different day. So we'll get into the couple of replays, show you what the gameplay is like a little bit. And I'm not going to go into the tank inspector and show you the armor profile because it's not worth looking at. Basically, you've got a gun mantlet, and that's it. So, let's go check it out. Okay, so we're on airfield, and I am a tier 8 in a tier 9 game. It's kind of weird because we have a tier 6 tank and a tier 5 tank. I don't really understand why they're here. They shouldn't be here. I think the AMX should get into tier 8 games. I think the T21 should only see tier 8 games, probably as well. Only tier 7 and tier 8 tanks, I think, should see higher matchmaking. Like the Chaffee seeing tier 10s is ridiculous. So I'm using the 85mm gun, and I'm trucking up to the middle here. As you can see, I'm actually going faster than the ELC, which is pretty cool, considering how fast that tank is. And I thought he would maybe go up the left side of the hill, but instead he just decided he was gonna suicide, which was great. So he drives up there, he spots the 5120, which really didn't account for a heck of a lot because now he's one shot from death, and this E50 is gonna go down and kill him. So, that's how you don't scout. That's how you get people hating scout drivers. And I had a shot here, maybe at the ELC AMX. Where are you, ELC? Alright, so I killed him. That's one of their scouts down. So scouts getting into really, really hyper aggressive positions that get them stranded like that, not a good idea. This tank drives pretty good on sand and other surfaces. It's one of the things that I do like about the tank, is its ground resistance happens to be pretty good. So I'm pulling up here, and I get spotted by the T71. At this point, I still didn't have sixth sense. I have it now, but at this point, I didn't. So imagine how fun it is fighting against Waffenträger of Panzer IV, hiding in the back. You can see him down here. He's hiding back here. And I popped up, and he's hiding behind some bushes, and I didn't see him. So I think scouts need a skill that's like find hiding TD in the back that can, so you can see through bushes sort of thing. But until that happens, yeah, not gonna happen. So I can see that T71 has moved up, and I don't really like going up into this area here as much because you get shot. And I don't really have a lot of backup. I've got a T29 who is cleverly hiding in the back behind some bushes because he's got a highly accurate sniper tank. And we got an ISU-152. So I can't really leave this area. I'd like to go fight it out with that T71 a little bit, but there's too many tanks here that I need to be popping up and spotting just to make sure that they don't advance because almost the entirety of my team isn't over here. But I've killed one ELC, so that's all that really matters. To my right, we do have a Leopard prototype. T29. I asked the T29 to move up. He kind of shifted his tank around for about 4 seconds, popped out of the bush. And then he thought, you know what? I'm gonna stop. But I've spotted an E50 who's coming across the field here, and I'm going to put a whole load of hurt into him. So this is where the DPM of this gun matters to me. So I shoot him, manage to track him, and now he's getting circled by the PTA. I keep him tracked, and now he's dead. So that's basically why I like this gun. If you can get into a position where you're not the tank that he's concentrating on, you can do stuff like that. And me being able to shoot 4 or 5 times into the side of him really made a big difference. If that I was shooting with the 250 or the 100mm gun, I mean, things probably wouldn't have turned out quite as good. So I was hoping this T29 would just kind of like back me up around this corner here, but instead he tried to take on the T30 head on, which really wasn't a great idea. You can see I've got a SFL coming up, poking around a little bit. And you can see also that there's that tank destroyer has moved himself out of the bushes. I'll get greeted by one of his shells later on in this game. Yeah, that's not really that funny though. Getting shot by a tank destroyer when you're in a scout tank is just kind of like salt in the wound. So up north, we've done pretty well. Yeah, and the T-29 is fairly smart right there. And we've got a bore sig that's come over to help us as well. So I'm poking up, and gun depression, not the strong suit of this tank. I missed my first shot on this tank destroyer, and just as I reload, he gets out of my view range again. So I've spotted this guy here, and I only took a 300 damage hit from him. I assume that he was pretty stock. So I shoot him again, and I start backing up. At this point, I should have stayed down for about 4 or 5 more seconds to get off the radar, because I get hammered by Johnny hiding TD in the back. And our T-29 is still alive. That's good. So I was hoping I would get a shot at the Leopard, but I don't. But I do have a shot at this M12, and I wasn't sure whether he was going to go this way or that way. But 0.34 accuracy, I was able to get a pretty nice shot in there and take him out. And I can hurt this Leopard PTA, so I'm gonna try and get up here. And he's down to 38 health, and thank you. So he's dead. And we ended up winning that game. I ended up getting 5 kills, mostly because I was able to get the last shot in and finish off guys. More like a closing game than anything else. But 12 shots out, 10 shots hit, and with 10 penetrations, I got to shoot some of the softer targets in the game. And 1500 damage isn't amazing or anything in a 132, but it was pretty decent for this game. I had a good team up north, and I was able to spot and kind of just be annoying to the enemy team until I was able to finish off basically a whole bunch of tanks when we started sweeping in from the north. Only about 760 spotting damage, so it wasn't the best spotting in the game. But I think that the 85 here showed off how accurate it is, and at range you can shoot guys pretty well as long as they're not too heavily armored. Like if I was shooting at an E-50 or a Conqueror or a Yag Tiger or probably a T-30 from these ranges, I wouldn't have penetrated anything. So I just got lucky that I was able to shoot at the tanks that I was able to shoot at. See in the front, that's where that big shot went through. And it actually didn't kill any of my crew members or break anything, which was kind of amazing since it did like probably about 800 damage to me. I did take 2 hits in this game, one of them being from the SFL and the other one coming from something over in this general direction. I assume it was the that nasty Waffenträger. So we'll jump on the next replay. And unfortunately, the second game happened to be in Erlenberg, a map that I completely hate and despise, and will finally be removed and replaced with a different Erlenberg with different spawn points and some improvements made to it. And hopefully, it'll be a lot better. I never got to play the upgraded Erlenberg on the other server, but in this game here, I decided to go up north and try and get some spots and see what I could find on the enemy team that was going to try and cross the river. So I'm being fairly brazen driving across the top of here, and I spot the T-30. For whatever reason, he didn't spot me, because I think I had sixth sense at this point, and I'm still using the 85 mm. So I'm just poking around. You don't have any bad gun depression off shooting, off eight, like having your turret off the back of the tank either, which is quite nice. So kind of ISA. We got a lot of the team that has moved its way up here. In fact, the majority of the team moved its way up here. And a 5100 managed to die right there. So spot T30 here. Put a shot onto him, but he's gonna get annihilated by the 1375 and the two leopards right there. So made short work of him, and we've got a T28 here, so I thought I'd shoot the roof. That would break the roof a little bit more, but it didn't. Right now he's outside of my range to spot. And those Leopard prototype A's have the same view range as me, same with the 1390, so it's not like I'm too special here. So this is the part where I was a bit like I was popping up, and the second I popped up, I got spotted. And if you look at how far away I was, that's like 50 meters, 150, 250, 350. I was kind of hoping that I wouldn't have been spotted at 350, 350 meters, because I know certain other tanks, they can get, like, they can be in open ground and they don't get spotted until they're like 270 meters away. But this guy managed to shoot me at 350 meters, so it really didn't seem to matter whether I had camo on or on all my guys, and if this tank had a good camo rating at all. You'll see in a sec here. Yeah, my light bulb didn't even go off, actually. I had sixth sense at this point. So I was a little bit annoyed. I was a little bit pissed off. And honestly, there's no real reason for me to be trying to shoot at this guy, other than trying to spot him and stuff. And we've got enough tanks over here that can see him better than I can anyway. And they have better gun depression than me. So Freddy took a big hit there in his 1375. And see that there? That's me getting spotted by the T28 and him going invisible right in front of me. So basically, this game has said that tank destroyers get to be invisible in open sight, but scout tanks do not. And for me, that just kind of makes me not even want to play this tank hardly anymore. Like, I want to play it for team battles, but for this kind of battle here, where I have to fight T28s and stuff, it's just like, why? Like, I don't understand. Either way, I decided to bug out and head over to the south side of the map. See, Arson is 1390, and we're getting out of here. Yeah, and I don't want to try and rant and rave about scout tanks, light tanks, and the spotting system too much, but it's just one of the things that continually just drives me nuts about this game. So I'm chucking along here, see I'm doing about 65. And compared to the 1390, I think I should be able to go a fair bit faster than him, seeing as how he can do like 13 or 1400 damage in a clip to virtually any tank, because he has APCR with 250 pen. So we've got a T-54 coming this way, and unfortunately Farty decided to stop and take some shots at, I don't know, a scout tank or something. So it was just me and Arson that were going up to this T-54. And now he's started moving across. So I'm gonna park up here because I want to try and get side shots on this guy. So I pump one into him, Arson pumps another one into him. He's got him turning. So that one tracked him. This one's going into his engine. And now he's dead. So the scout tanks did a good job there. We managed to do some good stuff to him. And now I'm shooting at a WZ-120, and I really didn't expect to be able to do damage to him, so I've bounced two shots shooting at him with my 172 pen. That one bounced again, but I'll keep shooting at him. Maybe something will go in somehow. And I don't know why that went in. I don't know what chink in the armor I found there, but he got tracked, and then he got spun around, and then he got killed. So some people get mad when three scout tanks get taken into a game. I've had people rage on me before about it, but in this game, it happened to work out pretty good because scout tanks did quite a lot of damage considering this kind of firepower that we have. And this is another instance of this gun being awesome, being able to shoot really far. Very accurate, and against soft targets like that M445, you'll be able to do that all day. So I've got a VK over here, and I'm just trying to stay as far away from enemy tanks as possible, because obviously they see me before I see them most of the time. So I've tracked that VK in place, and I'm trying to get a shot at him here, and there he is. He's done. So VK28 killed. And my team is spotting for me, so see this Pershing here. Put a 200 damage shot into him. And he's dead. We're living it. We're winning 12-7. Let's see across this weird bouncy ground here. The tank's still doing around 58 going downhill. That's one of the things I like about this tank, and I wish the maps were bigger so you could exploit its speed faster to move around quicker. If we had like 2 kilometer size maps, that'd be great. And I could blast around, it'd be cool. So I'm swinging as wide as I can because I know my camo doesn't really work, especially against J-Panther 2s that might be running binos or that T-28 who sees me before I can see him. I'm still blown away that he was able to shoot me without my sixth sense going off. That was awesome. So now I'm humming along here. I've got my two beat up friends with me. I can take a couple shots from whatever's back here. Well, one shot from the Jag Panther and then anything else will kill me, but being a little bit cautious, my friends are going to the left hill, and I don't know, that probably wasn't me spotting this Tiger 2, but it's me shooting him, and this is the DPM of this gun again that I really like. I was hoping I would get his turret there. He's right on the edge of my render range. And he shot, and I think that's what got him spotted, but it was probably Arson spotting him and not me. So I'm gonna move up, see if I can get some more effective shots at this guy. And yes, if you're wondering where the J-Panther was hiding, it was back here. A0. So I got side shots on the Tiger 2. And he's dead. And that's 3 kills for me. So at this point, I know where the tank destroyers are. The T-28 is somewhere in here, and the other guy is hiding somewhere over here. I just knew he was over here. And And when I'm this close, that tank destroyer is going to spot me before I spot him. And I think that was maybe me spotting him. So I took a shot at that T-28 and it didn't go in. And now the only tank left here is the J-Panther, and I didn't really want to get shot and killed by him. Because if he tracked me, he probably would have reloaded and been able to kill me. So I was still being pretty careful here. Waiting for some of my teammates to get a little bit closer. SU-101 is coming across. And he shot our Tiger II, so I decided to move up at this point. And I've got side shots here. And I tried to track him and pin him in place, but didn't work. Shoot him in the lower plate. And now I'm just sitting here. And the last one goes in. So I really like this tank. There's the shortcomings of the game, basically, and the spotting system that I hate and everything else, but for the most part, it moves really fast. The turret turns really well. It shoots in the move pretty well. It has two pretty decent guns that you can use. One's a DPM gun, one is more of a heavier alpha gun in the 100 millimeter. I prefer the 85. The tank has basically no armor, and when you get hit, a lot of stuff usually goes wrong with it because it doesn't have a lot of hit points on its modules or its crew. I don't really find that the camouflage works on it, and I might actually take it off because I just don't find that it really works. I mean, I don't know how many games I've had where I've been driving around and I'll get spotted by tank destroyers that are sitting out in the open. And I know they're out in the open, and they'll find me and they'll shoot me on the move, even though I'm supposed to have good camo value on the move. So I've been less impressed with the camo and stuff on this tank, but it's fast, it's fairly low profile, it's not very big, it has nice punchy gun, and overall, I don't really have too many things I dislike about it. Other than, it has no armor, but it's a light tank, it's not supposed to. So, would I recommend going down this line? If you want to play it in team battles and stuff, it's great. Is it fun to play against tier 10 tanks? Not really. You can usually only get hit once or twice before you're completely toast, and a lot of times when you get hit by some of those guns, you really pay for it. So, in the end, if you want to play this tank for team battles, I recommend it for sure. Pub battles, it's not very fun. Sometimes, like, I've had a few games where I've done a lot of damage, and like this game here where I did 2800 and did 1400 spotting damage and stuff. I've had other games where I've done 4 or 5,000 spotting damage, and those games are fun and stuff, but you've got to be so passive when you're in the tier 10 games doing passive bush scouting that it's not quite as fun, because my tank isn't set up to do passive bush scouting. It's more set up to do, pop out and aggressive attack type scouting, kind of doing a rush to go kill artillery, things like that. Mine's more set up that way. So I wish you could actually swap setups on this tank, and it would be adaptable to what kind of map it was or what the enemy team was or something, but you're never going to get that. So that's the WZ-132. Thanks for watching. I'll see you again next time.